Can you hear me? Okay, okay. So the recording is ready?
Yes, sir, it's ready.
Okay, okay. So what you can do after my question answer session, you can stop the recording. I don't know whether Selvaraj ji will want it recorded. I don't know. Selvaraj, you want it recorded or you don't want it recorded? I can't hear you. You're silent.
Mine is okay, sir. I don't want to be recorded.
Then what you can do, as soon as I finish the question answer, you can stop the recording. And Pradesh, sir, you can just WhatsApp me that link or put it on a Google Drive and send me the link by WhatsApp or something.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Or you can put it on some Dropbox or something. So as soon as I finish the question answer, you can stop the recording, because this probably it is proprietary. Mine is slightly open, so no problem.
Okay, sir. Okay. Ma'am, Radha, ma'am.
Namaskar, sir.
Ma'am, the recording.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's ready.
What's happening when SAR section is over?
Okay, sir.
You stop that one. We don't want Salomar sir's recording. Okay, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
When the question section is over, you can stop and give the link.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Namaskar.
Venkatesh sir.
Namaskar sir, I am present sir.
Yes sir.
Shall I begin sir?
Master of ceremony by you only, no sir?
Yes sir, I will begin sir.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes sir.
Yeah, okay, we will wait for 5 minutes more.
Okay sir, okay sir. Namaha. My humble pranams to the love-wounded lotus feet of our beloved Amma. Pranams to the resource persons. Pranams to principal, teachers, parents and dear children. Career guidance program is held every year in our Amrit Vidyalayams to help children plan and step into their future. Career guidance helps one to take a journey on which they could develop and make themselves mature and take informed decisions. Let us begin today's section with Amma's blessings. I would like to call upon Akshaya NS to chant Amma's Dhyana slogan. Over to Akshaya.
स्निग्धापाङ्ग विलोकिनीं भगवतीं मन्दस्मिता श्रीमुखीं वात्सल्यामृतवर्षिणीं सुमधुरं सङ्कीर्तनालापिनीं श्यामाङ्गीं मधुसिक्तसूक्तिं अमृतानन्दात्मिकामीश्वरी ॐ गुरुब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सह त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वम् अमृतेश्वर्यै मा ॐ सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
थैंक यू May I call upon our principal, sir, Amrutha Dhyanam Kanyakumari, to welcome and introduce the guest.
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Amrutheshwaraye Namaha. My humble pranams to love-bounded lotus feet of our beloved Amma. Pranams to correspondent Amrutha Vidyalayam, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. Academic Director Sri Ganapathi Pillai, sir. Guest speakers, dear parents, teachers, and my beloved children, Namah Shivaya to all. Today, in this evening, I am immensely pleased to welcome our guest speaker, Sri Prashant R. Nair. To the society and for the welfare of the student community by organizing Anoka Tech Fest top student event of IEEE, CSI, IETE, ACM and the 29th National Student Convention. Sir has been awarded with Computer Science of India Academic Excellence, Star Faculty of Amrita, Best Academic Administrator, Global Chapter Achievement Award, Best Faculty of the Year 2018, by Computer Society of India and many more. Sir has also published many valuable books. We are really happy and very fortunate to have such an eminent person who always comes willingly amid his busy schedule to take career guidance and counseling for our students of Amrutha Vidyalayam Kanyakumari. On behalf of Amrutha family at Kanyakumari, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you, Namshiva. Thank you.
Next, I would like to welcome our competitive coaching coordinator, Amrutha Vidyalayam, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, Sri Selva Kumar sir. Sir is a successful person in mentoring students for various competitive examinations like NEET, JEE, IIT, TNPSC, bank exams, etc. He served as a member in conducting bank mock interviews at various public sector banks. Sir has appeared for different competitive exams and has cleared many stages. We are happy to have sir with us as a coordinator for molding our students in the competitive exams. On behalf of Amrutha family at Kanyakumari, we welcome you, sir, for this career guidance counseling webinar in this evening. Next, I welcome my dear children and parents for this career guidance and counseling webinar. Once again, welcome you all. Namah Shivaya. Today, in this evening, we are going to be enriched with our guest speakers, Sri Prashant R. Nair, on the topic, What Suits Me Next? And with our coordinator, Sri Selva Kumar sir, on the topic, Civil Service, a Worthwhile Career. Thank you. Namah Shivaya. Over to Prashant sir.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. Om Namah Shivaya. Good afternoon to all the people gathered here, Principal Sri Pradeesh Kumar, various faculty members of Amrita Vidyalayam Kanyakumari, my fellow resource person Sri Selva Kumar, who's doing an excellent job of coordinating the career guidance and competitive exams academy of the Amrita Vidyalayams in Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, and dear children, Namashivaya, it's a great happiness for me to continue this event. Interestingly, this is the 8th year of the mentoring for Amrita Vidyalayams in Tamil Nadu and Pondicherry. It's almost 8 years since we have started this. Till last year, I was regularly coming into your school, visiting and interacting you one to one. But unfortunately, because of this pandemic, especially the second wave of the pandemic, there is no other way but to go online. I completed the Trichy, Tirupur, Nagapattinam, Ramnad, Thoothukudi schools all in online mode, the career counseling. Except Ettimadai in late February, I was able to go online. I go in person and interact with the people, because I just stay inside the campus in Coimbatore, the Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham campus. So it was very easy for me to go and do this. Let me start by sharing my slides. Just 1 minute. Is my slide visible? Is my slide visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Today, the agenda for today's career and course options and counseling session is essentially to give you a bird's eye view on the various options available in terms of the various courses and programs that are available. So basically, I will give you a quick overview of 5 different streams of courses and programs, namely engineering, sciences, health and medical sciences, arts, media and commerce, and management. I'm not going to cover anything about the civil services, government jobs, etc. That will be covered by Sri Selva Kumar. So initially, I will be trying to give you an understanding on the importance of choosing a career, some simple tips on how to choose the career, and then this broad options, I will give you a quick overview. And we can answer questions for maybe 20 minutes or something. If it crosses the time, you can email me those questions and I can answer them. Now, essentially, my experience in Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, Coimbatore, years here in this campus, I have primarily been involved in administration activities, several administrative activities, especially coordinating the rankings, the accreditation, the quality cell. And in that capacity, I have been very regularly visiting the other campuses of Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham. Today, Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham has more than 20,000 students, 1,600 faculty, more than 150 plus programs in all disciplines, health sciences, medicine, humanities, sciences, biotechnology, nanotechnology, journalism, agriculture. Except for law, almost every single program is available in one of the campuses. And today, Amrita is India's number one private university. The government of India's rankings has ranked Amrita as the 4th best university in India out of more than 1,000 plus universities. And among the private, we are number one. This is no mean achievement. And during my experience, I have been very closely interacting with several of the colleagues in all the campuses of the Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham in Mysore, in Bangalore, Chennai, Amritapuri, which is near Kollam, Kerala, where Amma is, and Kochi. All the campuses have been extensively interacting, whether it is medical or health sciences or Ayurveda. So there, that has given me a very good experience and exposure in the sense that I am able to have a fairly good idea about all these disciplines, all these programs, as also be able to at least answer many of your queries, especially with respect to entry, exit, and the subtle differences that are there. So that's what I will be trying to answer your questions. I want to spend maximum time on these questions. I will request the organizers, the principal, to please share these slides with all the children today. I understand all of you are 12th standard students of Amrita Vidyalayam, Kanyakumari. I would request you to please share all these slides today itself by WhatsApp to all the students so that they are able to refer to these slides whenever they are available. And as soon as you give the video, I will also add it to my YouTube channel. So that's the pretty much the agenda for today. So I start this presentation with a very beautiful and wonderful quote, a vision statement given by Amma, who is the Acharya of the Amrita Vidyalayam and the Chancellor of Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham. Her Holiness Sadguru Shri Mata Amritanandamayi Devi, affectionately known as Amma, world-renowned humanitarian leader, plays a very, very active role in guiding and inspiring all the activities at the Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, as also the Amrita Vidyalayams. And it is singularly because of Amma's inspiration, Amma's guidance, Amma's motivation and strategic direction that today Amrita is second to none with respect to the universities in India. We are a very young university. We have only been become a university in 2003. In a short span of 18 years, this university has gone from strength to strength and emerging as the fourth best university in India and the top private university. And it has happened singularly because of the inspiration of Amma. And Amma says her vision for education is providing education for both living and life. Now let us understand what is meant by education for living and education for life. Education for living is giving you the tackles and tools to be able to earn your livelihood, giving you the best exposure, giving you the best facility, the best faculty, the best ambience, the best infrastructure, and the best competencies by virtue of which you are able to shine in whatever discipline you have chosen. You are able to earn your living. There is nothing wrong in earning money. Let me be very honest about this. There is nothing wrong in earning money. Money is needed for all of us. Each one of us has to take care of our family. Each one of us has to take care of the community. So there is nothing wrong in earning a livelihood. It is very important for each one of us to earn our livelihood. And you get the best exposure, all facilities, infrastructure, faculty, ambience, everything for getting the best education. And that is the education for living. But not everybody is able to give you the education for life. Education for life is living a dharmic life. You may be very, very successful as a doctor. You may be very successful as an engineer. You may be very successful as a social worker. You may be very successful as a journalist. But are you living your life in service of the society? Are you living a dharmic life? Are you blending an ethical dimension to your activities? Are you blending virtues and values and the culture that is needed for the society? That is a question. So education is not only for living, getting a livelihood, earning money, but also to be a responsible citizen somebody who lives a dharmic life, somebody who contributes to the society, contributes to the community, contributes to the country. And at Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham and Amrita Vidyalayams, this is the motto, this is the vision. Education is for both living and life. All of you children have already gone through this experience. You have been part of an Amrita Vidyalaya, where Amma is the Acharya, Amma is the inspiration. I take this opportunity to extend an appeal and a clarion call to each one of you. Please consider Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham University as one of your destinations for higher education. I know you are all in the 12th standard. You are very excited. There is a pandemic running amok. Competitive exams are all got postponed. And many of you are looking at various options. Your parents are looking at various options. But please do consider the Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham, because you will get the best education, the best facility, the best ambience, the best infrastructure, the best faculty. At the same time, you continue your journey, a journey into an education for life, where you are prepared to face the vagaries of nature, face the uncertainty that is there in the world, and become a very dharmic individual, an ethical individual who respects and tolerates every aspect of human life. So with this fervent appeal, please do consider our university as your choice for higher education. I move on to my slide. Now, this is a very good definition of career. I think it comes from the Webster's definition of career. A very interesting take on career, which says, a career is a profession or occupation with opportunities for advancement or promotion, and not just livelihood. Just rewind back to the last slide. Amma says education is for both living and livelihood. Here also, the definition talks about not only livelihood, which is living, but also opportunities for advancements or promotion. Advancement in the sense that it is there for you to support the society, to contribute to the society, to contribute to the humanity, to contribute to the world. So even this definition of career sort of echoes what Amma has been beautifully explaining in the vision for Amrita University, Amrita Vidyalayams, and so on. Now, what influences your career? Your choice of career is influenced by a whole lot of various influences, which is mentioned in this slide as the career planets. I will explain. You have some preference. You have some talent. You have some competency. You have some capability. You have some skill set. You have some ambition. You have some aspiration. Each one of us has that. That is referred here as the self and the vision. The self and the vision refer to your skill set, your capability, your talent, your competency, your aspirations, your ambitions. So this is one very important influence on your choice of a career, the self and the vision. The second influence is your education, the exposure that you get in the school, the ambience that you get in the school, the facility that you get in the school, the teachers who motivate you, the faculty who mentor you at all stages of your school education. These also influence your choice of a career. The third is your family. When I say family, it refers to not only your parents, your brothers and sisters, your uncles, your grandparents, but your extended family. Your extended family. It includes your friend circle, your family friends, your neighbors, your relatives. Everybody provides inputs. Everybody gives you inputs that sort of influence your choice of a career. Now, I'm sure somebody would have told you, you know, some neighbor or some relative would have told, பக்கத்துல வீட்டுல அந்த பையன் பிடெக் முடிச்சிருக்கு, அமெரிக்காவுக்கு போய் எம்எஸ் முடிச்சிருக்கு, இப்போ இவ்வளவு சம்பாதிக்கிறாங்க. These kind of influences are also there. So we saw, first is self and vision. Self and vision is your skill set and your talent. Vision is your ambition and aspiration. This is one major influence for your career. Your education and exposure that you got in the school is the second influence for your choice of career. Your family and extended circle is the third influence for your career. And finally, the society at large also influences your decisions with respect to selection of a career. The society is very, very open. Today, we are living in a society where there is an explosion of information. Information is freely available. You open your phone, there are 100 WhatsApp messages. 100 WhatsApp messages. Today, I'm told that there is a lockdown in Tamil Nadu. One of my colleagues whom I met in the morning was telling, yesterday itself, there were WhatsApp messages which were leaked out from some government circles that a lockdown is going to happen soon. Information is so freely available. Not only that, there is an explosion of information. You open the television, you open the newspaper, you open the website, you open the internet, you open your WhatsApp message. So much of information is there. And all this information also influences each one of us towards the selection of career. Because the information is only but a reflection. The information that is available on the media is only a reflection of the society. A reflection of the society comes as the information. So we are influenced by self and the vision, our ambition and our talent. We are influenced by our school and our exposure in the school, the education. We are influenced by our family and extended family. We are influenced by the society, which is today Abbas, which is having an explosion of information. So please understand how you are being influenced. Now we have to use this influence properly. I will give you an example. Today there is a social media platform that all of us know, the social media platform of Facebook. There are 2.6 billion people on Facebook. Imagine 2.6 billion people. One out of three living souls in this planet have got access to Facebook. They are using this social media platform called Facebook. If Facebook was a country, it is the largest country in the world. 2.6 billion people. Next comes China, 1.5 billion. And then India, 1.3 billion. Nobody can deny this mass appeal, this influence that Facebook has today. Now the question is, how do you use this Facebook? You can use this social media platform called Facebook to coordinate and collect relief activity for COVID pandemic. Today we are now suffering the second wave of the pandemic. We can use the social media platform to collect and collate and distribute and coordinate relief activities. You can also use this platform to instigate a riot, to instigate a disturbance in some place. Both are possible. Now the question is, what would you prefer to do? That is where the education for life comes in. The education for life that focuses on being an ethical, socially conscious, dharmic individual who will only focus all his energy while earning money in a career towards the benefit of the society. Now coming to the importance of choosing a career. Why should we choose a proper career? Why is this one of the most important decisions of our life? On an average, we spend almost 40 years on our work. 40 years. Some people may spend 50 years. Some people take VRS, voluntary retirement, into 25 years. But on an average, the work life of a person is 40 years. And this translates to almost 80,000 hours of work. Imagine one person's life. If a person's life is on an average is 65 years, we are working 40 years on the job or on the career. That translates to 80,000 hours. Is it not an important decision? Note, ask yourself, is it not a billion-dollar question? Is it not one of the most important decisions of life? How do I spend these 80,000 hours? How do I choose the best career which is contributing to the society? How do I use this career and live a life and not copy somebody else's life? Live a unique life. Now, my dear students, each one of us is unique. Each one of us is unique. Each one of us has a mandate in this world. God has created each one of us to fulfill a role, fulfill a destiny, do a mandate, contribute to the society, and each one of us has that mandate. And there is a clear proof of that. My fingerprint is unique. Your fingerprint is unique. If there are 7.8 billion people in this world, all 7.81 billion people are unique, and they have a unique fingerprint, which is only a testament that each one of us is unique. Each one of us has to play a role, and we have to play it in this life. Now, we do not know about the past life, if it was there. There is no scientific proving that. We do not know about our future life. Again, there is no way to scientifically prove it is there. So we only have this life. So how do we use this life for the best of your ability while earning money, while providing for your family, but in service of the society, the community, and the country? Now, I like to always quote one of my inspirations. All my classes, I take this quote from Steve Jobs. As you know, Steve Jobs is the founder of Apple. Somebody who promoted relentless innovation and completely changed the world. And Steve Jobs says, make your mark on the universe. Make a dent on the universe. Meaning that each one of us has got that capability to make our mark on the universe. Make a dent on the universe. Now, why do I admire Steve Jobs? Steve Jobs is known as the messiah of innovation. Relentless innovation, which transformed not one, but three industries. He, you know, his products in Apple innovated, namely the iPod, the iPhone and the iPad, transformed the music industry, the telephone, the mobile phone industry and the computer industry respectively. His devices transformed three industries. Nobody has contributed so much to design and innovation as much as him. I'll tell you the story. Many of your parents, maybe you have, your generation would have never seen what is known as a Walkman. Perhaps none of you might have seen even a tape recorder. Maybe your parents will definitely know what a tape recorder is or a Walkman is. It's a portable music player. You take that portable music player, you take a cassette. There is a cassette. You put the cassette. The cassette has got maybe 10 songs on one side, another 10 songs on the other side. So you flip it and you put that cassette. And you listen to music while you are traveling. 20 years back when I was in college, I remember, I never used to go travel without my Walkman. Then came a device called an iPod. A simple device, the size of your palm, the palm of your hand. It is only this size. 1,000 songs. And not only that, you can increase it to 10,000 songs. You can download songs from the internet. You can copy it across your devices. And what happened? Walkman vanished. Digital music became available. Tape recorders vanished. And all that started because of this Apple iPod. Fast forward a few more years. Then came a device called an iPhone. iPhone is a mobile phone, a revolutionary designed mobile phone with a single button. There is only a single button. I have been using an iPhone for the last 10 years. I do not plan to change the phone at all, plan to use it for the next 10 years also, a new model of an iPhone. It comes with a single button. Now, a lot of people were apprehensive in Apple when this single button innovation came. How can it work? For making a phone call, you need to have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. 9 numerals, 10 numerals are needed for making a phone call. But iPhone came with a single button. And iPhone was so simple in design, beautiful, aesthetic, sleek. Simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. That is what Steve Jobs used to say. Make things simple. People want things very simple, not complicated. Today, almost every phone comes with a single button or a double button. All phones come with single buttons, if I'm not mistaken. Then came an iPad. Portable computer. People stopped taking computers during travel. They were taking an iPad. Whenever I travel for conferences around the world, I just use an iPad. I don't take my computer. It's very heavy. I don't have to take my laptop. It's not so heavy, but I don't want to carry. It's easy to catch an iPad and go. Much easier. So, this messiah of innovation transformed music industry, transformed mobile phone industry, transformed computer industry. So it is so important that we choose the right career. We choose a career that puts it in the long term. We choose a career which we are passionate about simply because of the reason that it is not a small decision. It is a very, very important decision. We are spending 40 years or 80,000 hours on a career. And that is very, very a big number. And we need to take a decision which involves all the factors. I told you so many pressures are there. You have a vision, you have an ambition, you have an aspiration, you have a talent, you have some capability. Your school gives you inputs, the exposure in the school, the teachers give you input, your family and extended family give you pressure, give you inputs, and the society is abuzz with inputs. So peer pressure will be there throughout your life. It is part of the game in everybody else's life. My own life, if I see, there were pressures. My grandfather used to be the senior most IAS officer in the state of Kerala. He was the labor commissioner of Kerala. And even today, I remember when I was in seventh grade or sixth grade, we were abroad and we flew down to India because he had passed away, he expired. Even today, I remember that day of his expiry. That day, there was so much of commotion at home. My father and myself, I remember a lot of noise, a lot of cars coming, police and that. As a kid, even today, I remember that day because late, I didn't understand it at that point of time that somebody had come, that much I know. But the reason was that the chief minister of Kerala had come to pay respects. They were colleagues. And comfort my father and give some solace. And my grandfather always wanted me to, follow his footsteps into the IAS. To some extent, my dad also wanted that. But I chose a totally different path. I did not, I never even considered IAS as an option. I chose a totally different path. Couple of years back, I went and told my dad. So a couple of years back, I had a great opportunity to represent India as one of the mentors of the national hackathon team for representing India in a Singapore India hackathon. And our team came in the top five, and we were felicitated by none other than the Honorable Prime Minister of India in Singapore. And I came and told my dad, see, I'm sure grandfather will be very, very proud, even though I couldn't become an IAS officer or a cabinet secretary. See, I have a picture of the Honorable Prime Minister, a group photo where he, after before which he had felicitated and give us. You know, I'm sure that the choice of career in research, innovation bore fruit, and I'm very happy about it. So what I'm trying to say is that there will be pressures, but you have to take the best possible decision. One tool that we can use for taking the decision is what is known as a SWOT analysis. SWOT stands for strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. Strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. And we can do this SWOT analysis at different points of time. We ascertain our strength. We ascertain our weakness. We ascertain the opportunities outside in the market in terms of the careers and jobs. We ascertain the challenges that we may face in the future. And we can do this regularly. Ideally, your strength should be reflected in the opportunities in the market. That means your capabilities, your competence, your education, your skill set is in demand in the market. But in some cases, it may not be so. Your weakness is what is very hot in the market. What do you do? You can't be without a job. The only way is you convert your weakness into a strength. You are able to convert your weakness into a strength. So, you have to convert your weakness into a strength. And every time, periodic intervals, you can do this SWOT analysis. Ascertain your strength, ascertain your weakness, ascertain your opportunities in the market, and ascertain the threats of the challenges that you will face in the future. This is a very good tool that one can use at periodic intervals at time. Now, maybe you go for a career, you take a job. after 5 years you find out that the opportunity outside is dwindling, it is coming down. You have to be intelligent enough to change your line of work, change your career to somewhere where there is some sort of scope and demand. There is no point in converting, continuing in a career that is going to slowly die down. It is like the example of a Walkman. If you are a company making Walkmans, you should understand in the future nobody is going to buy a Walkman. You go on making Walkmans, nobody is going to buy, and you are only going to lose money and nobody is going to buy. So you should be flexible enough to do SWOT analysis at periodical intervals of time. Now I want to give you some specific tips which can be used in any career. These are simple tips that one can use before choosing any kind of career. One is, be part of the solution and not be part of the problem. Do you want to be part of the solution or do you want to be part of the problem? The world needs problem solvers, not problem creators. The world needs people who can work in teams and groups across disciplines, across branches, across silos, and contribute to the society. I'll give you an example. Smart city. It's a very nice concept. Smart city. What makes a city smart? The smart building, the smart education, the smart hospital, the smart car, the smart transportation pathway, the smart traffic light. Only then will become a city become smart. Who has to make it smart? Each one of us. The teacher or the educator will have to change his style of teaching to become smart. The doctor will have to change his diagnosis style and reporting to become for smart healthcare. The car driver will have to understand GPS technology to become a smart, to use a smart car. The smart building designer, the architect, will have to design in such a way that the building is designed smart. So everybody has to contribute, and all the problems require these kind of multifunctional, multidisciplinary, interdisciplinary collaboration and cooperation and communication. Everybody has to pitch in. Now in the process, you will be working with all kind of people. People from different countries, different communities. And you need to respect that. Respect diversity. The bonds that unite us are much more than the things that separate us. We need to respect all kind of people. Because we are now today living in a global village. We are all living in a global village today. Today, if you read the newspaper, all the countries are supporting India, providing relief material for COVID pandemic. Every country is actually competing. If US is sending 5 tons, 5 planes, European Union wants to send 10 loads of relief material. Why? Because we helped them when they needed it. When India was subsiding in the first phase of the pandemic, US was suffering with the second wave of the pandemic. India provided a lot of medicines, vaccines. They came out of the pandemic. Now we are in trouble. They are helping us. It is give and take. Only if we give the vaccine, he will give you the raw material to make the vaccine. So the world is a global village. We have to collaborate, communicate. We cannot live in an isolated fashion. And in that respect, whichever career you choose, as a doctor, as an engineer, as a scientist, as a journalist, as a social worker, as a pharmacist, please learn to respect diversity. We cannot live without each other. You know, the Indian concept is, Vasudevaka Kudumbam, the whole world is one family for, that is what Indian culture talks about. And we in our career should learn to respect diversity. Because the whole world needs problem solvers. People who are from different disciplines, who work together, who contribute towards the benefit of the society. The last point that I want to talk to you is about the time management. Time management is very, very important. And somehow, unfortunately, we Indians have lost that plot. Somehow we do not want to be punctual. In fact, when we say 10 o'clock, that is our attitude, unfortunately. Some people even say that IST, Indian Standard Time, has now become Indian Stretchable Time. We do not follow the time. We just don't care about the time. And in that process, what happens? We lose our face. Now, we are so crazy for so many things in the West. We are crazy for their Marvel Avengers movie. We are crazy for their Kentucky Fried Chicken and McDonald's. But why do not we copy? We are copying all these things. Their soft culture. Their cultural icons. But why do not we copy the Americans' punctuality? We do not. I have lived in the US for almost a year and a half. Not continuously. I've probably been there 7-8 times. And I've lived for small periods of time. And I have seen how dedicated and punctual they are. We have to learn punctuality from Westerners, people in US and Europe. Extremely punctual. If there is a meeting at 10 o'clock, you are expected to be there at 9:59. If he does not see you in by 10:05, if he 9:59, you have to reach there. If you don't come at 10, fine. 10:01, 10:02, by 10:04 or 10:05, he would have walked out and started the next meeting. They are so passionate about the time. I have seen in international conferences, at 11 o'clock, if there is a session to be planned, if there is a session planned at 11 o'clock, even if nobody comes, the speaker will start speaking. He will start speaking. He won't care if you are not there or they are not there. He doesn't care. He will start the thing. So what I'm trying to say is that it is very important that we keep the time, we be very, very time conscious and socially conscious. I'm going into the last part, that is the streams, but before that, some tips on what are some tips with respect to the career? What are some tips that we can use which help us in addition to a SWOT analysis to decide a person's career? This is in addition to the SWOT analysis. Suppose you are highly creative. You have a mechanical bent of mind. Mechanical bent of mind in the sense that you are able to, you build things. You are building contraptions. They give you some things, you are able to make a contraption. Or they give you some electronic components. You are able to create a new electronic device. They give you a computer, you are able to break down the computer, repair it and bring it back. That means you are having a mechanical bent of mind. You are having a creative bent of mind. Maybe you should look for engineering as a career. Some of you may be highly investigative, very much focused on getting to the root cause of the problem. how does this computer work? How does this mouse work? How does this webcam work? How does Google Meet work? You go on asking questions. How does this work? How does this work? You want to get to the root cause. Maybe you should consider a career in research. You are highly social. You like meeting people. You like meeting new people. You like interacting with people. You are very friendly and extroverted. You want to see different places. Maybe you should consider a career in journalism. You are highly rule based. You always like to follow the rules to the T. You always are uncomfortable when things are not in order. Things are not happening in order. You are very much focused on the rules. Maybe you should consider a career in accounts. You are highly enterprising. You like power, position, status. You like making others work for you and guiding them for the best result. Maybe you should focus on business or politics, or starting an enterprise or management, and so on, so that you can make others do your work. Additionally, if you are able to talk nicely, you are very good in conversation. Law is also a good option in addition to being enterprising and wanting power and status. So these are only pointers to some choices for the career. You are very artistic. You are good in drama, song, dance, and music, painting. Probably you should look for a career where you are good in, you can focus on artistic talent, and you can become highly famous and attain that kind of status. So these are only some guidelines that are there. Now, as I mentioned, I will be stressing upon five streams of programs for careers: engineering and allied courses, general science, medicine and health sciences, arts, media and commerce, and finally management. I'll quickly go through these slides. I hope will reach you by the end of the day, so that you can refer them, and if you have any more this thing, you can focus on, you can send an email or follow me, or send a message, and we can figure it out. Now, first, this thing is engineering branches. I think engineering branches are very common. All of you know, these are the popular branches listed here. Very popular branches. Computer science, CSE is computer science and engineering. ECE is electronics and communication engineering. Triple E is ECE is electronics and communication engineering. Triple E is electrical and electronics engineering, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, aerospace engineering, aeronautical engineering, chemical engineering, environmental engineering. Dear students, these are common branches. All of these are very popular branches of engineering, which all of you are aware of. But still, I want to, demystify some queries that I've been getting very regularly. What is the difference between aerospace and aeronautical engineering? Aerospace engineering is to do with the structure of the aircraft. It's a more of an outdoors job where you are focusing on the structure of an aircraft. Aeronautical engineering is focusing on the electronics of the aircraft, the communication systems with which the electronics with which the aircraft communicates with others and between others and to the tower. That is the aeronautical. What is the difference between ECE and EEE, electronics and communication engineering, and electrical and electronic engineering? Electronics is common to both, and there is a lot of overlap. In electronics and communication engineering, you are focusing on communication systems, radar, microwave applications, televisions, satellites. You are also focusing on the chips, the microprocessor inside your computer, the chip. You are focusing on the processors and the chips inside your television, inside your refrigerator, inside your air conditioner, by which you change the temperature and so on. That is the embedded system. That is electronics and communication engineering. Whereas electrical and electronics engineering, you are mostly focusing on the power systems, generating the power, distributing the power, conserving the power, the power plant, the motor, the generator. Those things we focus primarily in electrical and electronics engineering. So that is a subtle difference that is existing between the two. Now, what about CSE and IT? If you take CSE and IT, the fact of the matter is that both are identical. If you take the syllabus of all universities in India, IT and CSE are identical in nature. Actually, CSE has to focus more on software, and IT has to focus more on hardware. But in today's situation in India, the syllabus is identical in nature. So these are some of the common doubts that I get. But I want to also stress upon the fact that there are several branches of engineering whereby which are not so popular, not so common, but there is definitely a need in India and abroad for these branches. Shipping, merchant navy, agricultural engineering, architectural engineering, mining engineering, petroleum engineering, plastic engineering, polymer engineering, rubber engineering, tool engineering, ceramic engineering, textile engineering, leather engineering. Now, we also need people in these disciplines, but probably they are not so common, not so well known, but there are this many branches. And the ones that I showed you before, the CSE, ECE, EEE, mechanical, civil, chemical, are very common. So in engineering, there are a whole lot of disciplines not so well known. The second stream is general science. Please understand, sciences is not just physics, chemistry, biology, zoology, botany. Today, science has expanded. Sciences has become highly technology oriented. Sciences has become highly specialized. Sciences has become highly job oriented. Sciences careers have become highly in demand and high scope. There is a whole family of bio life sciences that we see today. Bio life sciences, biotechnology, bioengineering, microbiology, biochemistry, bioinformatics, genetic engineering, so many bio-related things. Forestry, dairy, fishery, rural studies, which are all related to bio. Also, we have somewhat relation in terms of the forward integration in terms of the food technology. The food processing, the nutritionist, the dietitian. So all these come under the bio life sciences family. It's a huge family. In that family, all of these come. Right? So in this sciences, there are also a few technology based programs. Meteorology, weather forecasting, geography, geographical information systems, geology, These are technology-based programs. So in sciences itself, you are seeing highly specialized, highly job-oriented, highly technology-based programs which are high demand. And many of these may be paying better than engineering or allied engineering fields. The third field is medicine. Medicine is the third stream that I want to focus on. In medicine, we know, we are very popularly known about medicine doctor, MBBS. Dental, Ayurveda and other Indian science, Indian systems of medicine, pharmacy, nursing. These are very common. Medical, dental, pharmacy, nursing, pharmacy. Medical, dental, pharmacy, nursing and alternate Indian systems of medicine like Unani, Siddha, Ayurveda and so on. But we have to also understand that these are not the only disciplines. There is a vast family of paramedical sciences, allied healthcare, allied medical programs that are high demand, high technology focus, highly job oriented. You can be an optometrist who takes care of the your eyesight, looks for the power of your eye. You can be a radiographer who takes care of the X-ray technician. You can be a medical technologist who looks into the into your blood. What is that? To the testing, the blood testing and the other kind of testing. You can be a speech therapist or an audiologist who helps a child to, with an impairment of speech to speak properly. You could be a physiotherapist, a physical occupational rehabilitation a specialist, a physiotherapist who is able to help somebody who had an accident to work properly. You could be a healthcare specialist, a hospital manager who designs the flow in a hospital. You are a patient, you go to a hospital, the doctor meets you, the doctor says you need to do a blood test, you need to do a urine test, you need to do a X-ray. You meet the doctor in the ground floor. You are already sick. Now for taking the X-ray, you have to go to the fifth floor. For buying the medicine, you have to go to the next building. For taking the urine test and the blood test, you have to go to the second floor. Please understand, you are already sick. Yes, there is somebody, a bystander with you who is helping you, but still, will you be in a position to run around? Nobody will want to run around. And that is why you need to design a hospital in such a way that the flow of the hospital is very efficient and very ergonomic and very easy for the patient. So there are a whole lot of paramedical sciences, allied health sciences there, which are very much job oriented and technology oriented and also having high scope and high demand. The fourth stream is arts, media and commerce. It's not only commerce. Perhaps commerce is the only program, BCom and MCom, where there is no talent needed. There is no talent needed for this. Apart from BCom and MCom, which are the only courses in this family of, in this stream of arts, media and commerce, all the other need high talent and high competence and high skills. You need to have a talent. If you want to become a newspaper journalist in print journalism, you need to have writing skill. If you need to become a blogger, an electronic journalist, you need to have writing skills, creative skills, design skills. If you want to become a television journalist, a celebrity in those lines, you need to have talent. You want to branch out to film making, documentary making, advertising, public relations, cartoonism, cartoonist, photography, cinematography. Without talent, you cannot do these things. You need talent. You want to be a jewelry designer, a textile designer, a fashion designer, an accessory designer, an interior designer. All of these needs talent. So apart from BCom and MCom, all other careers in the arts, media, and commerce stream, this family requires talent. Maybe some, event management. Even event management is may not be needing talent, but you need to be very, very, you need to be creative even in that, right? So these are the fourth stream, that is commerce. The last stream is management. And all of these management careers are generally at a post-graduation level. None of these are available at an undergraduate level, except maybe law. Law you can practice after a undergraduation, but it may not be enough. But all the other careers in the fifth stream, namely management, have to be at a post-graduation. Finance manager, marketing manager, factory manager, production manager, human resource manager, technology manager, bank manager, stock broker, investment analysis, insurance manager, actuarial manager, cost accountant, chartered accountant, cost and management accountant, company secretary. All of these are the family of careers that are available in the stream of management, but almost all of them are only available at the post graduation. And the last one is the civil services and the government jobs, which I will not be covering, which my colleague will cover. I think that's all from my side. I'll be very happy to answer some questions. I will suggest that the children can put it in the chat box and one of you can read it out for me, and so that quickly we can sing. We will do that for some 10-15 minutes, and then the other questions you can email it. Thank you very much. All the best. Please feel free to ask questions.